we've discussed the requirements for a potential flow, and basically the definition of a potential flow is that the velocity vector can be expressed as the gradient of some scalar that we're going to call the velocity potential. And when we plug that into the continuity equation, we get del dot v is equal to del squared phi, and this is called Laplace's equation. And as discussed before, there are a lot of solutions. Basically, what we're looking for is a scalar field phi that satisfies Laplace's equation, subject to boundary conditions on the surface of the object and in the far field. Now, the boundary conditions are a little bit tricky. So first, we're going to look at what are called elementary potential flows that are a set of scalar fields or phi velocity potentials that satisfy Laplace's equation. And then we're going to find that we can combine those in different ways in order to satisfy the boundary conditions. One nice thing about solutions to Laplace's equation is that if you find one solution like phi 1, you can add it to another solution like phi 2, which would give you phi 3, and phi 3, the summation of phi 1 and phi 2, will still satisfy Laplace's equation. And so basically we can come up with a bunch of solutions to Laplace's equation that can be combined in order to satisfy the boundary conditions that we need for our particular flow. So let's start by looking at some solutions to Laplace's equation. Perhaps the simplest is what's called a uniform flow. And a uniform flow is simply a flow where all of the velocity vectors are parallel to each other, and this can be in 3D. It's easier for me to show it in 2D, but in 3D, it's just where all these velocity vectors are aligned with each other. Now, the way that we would write the velocity potential for that phi, we would say that it's equal to vx times x plus vy times y. Let me fix that. Plus vz times z. So now when we take the gradient of phi, that gives us our velocity vector. That gives us vx in the x hat direction plus vy in the y hat direction plus vz in the z hat direction. So you can see that all we've recovered some velocity that is given by vx, vy, vz, and that's what we would call a uniform flow field if that velocity is constant throughout this space. So now we can prove that this satisfies Laplace's equation simply by looking at the second derivative of phi with respect to each of these. So if we look at del squared phi, that can be written as the derivative of phi with respect to x squared, or the second derivative of phi with respect to x squared, the second derivative of phi with respect to y squared, and the second derivative of phi with respect to z squared. And that has to equal zero in order to satisfy Laplace's equation. Well, we can look up here. At the first term, take the second derivative of this with respect to x. The first derivative is vx, and that's what went here. But then the second derivative is zero. Again, the first derivative of this term went in here. The second derivative with respect to y is zero. The first derivative of this term with respect to z went in here, and the second derivative is zero. So we can see that the second derivative, or del squared phi, of this uniform flow is equal to zero and satisfies Laplace's equation. Now, sometimes it's actually convenient to express uniform flow not in terms of vx, vy, and vz, but in terms of an angle of attack and velocity magnitude. And this actually only works in two dimensions if we're looking at a planar flow. So so if we say that all of these velocity vectors have a magnitude of V infinity, and they are angled by alpha here relative to the horizontal, then we can say that we can write phi, another way to express that would be that it's equal to V infinity times x cosine alpha plus y sine alpha. And so now when we take the derivative of that, V, which is equal to the gradient of phi, that's equal to V infinity times the cosine of alpha in the x direction, plus V infinity times the sine of alpha in the y direction. And then the z direction is equal to zero because this is a planar flow. So we're going to find that that's a useful way to express this, because we like to look at it in terms of velocity magnitude, V infinity, and an angle of attack, alpha. We're going to find that it's useful to have uniform flow not only in Cartesian coordinates, which we have over here, but also in cylindrical coordinates when we start to add it to other potential flows. So let's look at it in cylindrical coordinates. And the way that we do that transformation is by definition in cylindrical coordinates, we know that x equals r cosine theta and y equals r sine theta. And so we can just plug that into phi. If we just take what phi is here and swap that out. So phi is going to be equal to V infinity times, instead of x, we're going to put in r cosine theta. Then it's multiplied by cosine alpha. And then plus, instead of y, we're going to put in r sine theta times sine alpha. And we can rewrite this now as, we can pull out the r basically, as V infinity times r cosine theta cosine alpha plus sine theta, excuse me, that's a theta, times sine alpha. Okay, now there happens to be a trigonometric identity that says that this summation here, the cosine of one angle times the cosine of another plus the sine of the first angle times the sine of another, can be rewritten as cosine theta minus alpha. And so then we can just bring down the V infinity times R, and that gives us our phi. So that's our velocity potential in cylindrical coordinates. Now we just take the gradient of that in cylindrical coordinates, and I won't work through that. I'll just write out the solution here, but V equals the gradient of phi. If we do that in cylindrical coordinates, we get V infinity times cosine of theta minus alpha, and that is in the R direction, minus sine of theta minus alpha in the theta direction, and zero in the z direction. And I have the brackets here, so those brackets mean that V infinity is multiplied through that entire expression. So that gives us our equations for this uniform flow in cylindrical coordinates.